So second application I am thinking like this. Second way of asking question, for example, they will give the question like this. The light is incident normally on the one of the refracting surface. Light incident normally on the one of the refracting surface. Light incident normally on refracting surface and comes out through the second surface, comes out through the second surface, refracting normally on refracting surface, coming out through the second surface, grazing emergence. Grazing emergence, I will explain to you. Light is incident normally on grazing on refracting surface, coming out through the second surface, grazing emergence, then refractive index of the prism This is the way of generally asking question, but I want to analyze this, how many questions they can put in the paper setting wise. Okay, so most of the students, they are confused with this survey, with this term, normally on refracting surface. Normal means according to mathematics wise it is 90 degrees, but according to physics normal is not 90. Why? Because incident means angle between the incident light and normal, this angle is called angle of incidence, but light of normal and incidence are coincide, means angle between them is what? Zero. I1 is zero, very important thing. Normal incidence means I1 is zero. I think so you observe this, your light is not bending at the refraction. Not bending at the refraction means R1 is also equal to what? Zero. Yes, come to the second surface. Come to the second surface. Grazes at the second surface. All of you understand, I think so. Grazing means 90 degrees. Grazing means 90 degrees. Most of the people are confused with this grazing, sir. Grazing means they write it as zero. Wrong. Your angle is measurement with normal. Normal and grazing surface is 90. Then I2 equal to 90 degrees. Very important thing. You know, I think so, previous topic known as TIR, total internal reflection. When light travel from denser to rarer, the angle of incidence is in such a way that refracting angle is 90, then that angle of incidence is called critical angle. 2 marks, very important bit. Angle between the, when light travel from denser to rarer medium, incidence is in such a way that refracting angle is 90, that incidence is said to be critical angle. Now your I is nothing but, according to my previous diagram, it is R2. R2 equal to what? C. Very important thing. Now in this case, your condition known as mu equal to sine of A plus D by 2 by sine A by 2 is failed condition. Very important thing. You should not approach the problem like this. Why? It is applicable only at minimum deviation. Now your condition of minimum deviation, already I said with you, at minimum deviation, what is the condition? R1 equal to R2, I1 equal to I2, it should be there. But it is not like that. Then, my request please, don't go for this. This is a wrong concept because it is applicable at minimum deviation. I specified with you clearly. Limitation is there for that law. Now, sir, but which one is applicable to solve this problem? Snell's law. Mu1 sin I equal to mu2 sin R. That only the basic rule. So mu1 sin I equal to mu2 sin R. One more condition. You observed or not, at first refracting surface, I don't have right to apply the condition like that. Why? Because sin 0 by sin 0 undefined. I can apply only one condition, sir, that is at second refracting surface. That is, light move from denser to rarer. Mu1, mu, sin I is nothing but sin C, is equal to, sir, mu2, 1, sin R, sir, sin 90. All of you know, I think so, from your mathematics. Sin 90 is what? 1. Mu equal to what, sir? 1 by sin C. This is the way to determine the refractive index. For example, if they give me refractive index as, for example, if they give refractive index as root 2 for me, mu equal to root 2, then I am going to apply like this. Root 2 equal to 1 by sin C, C equal to sin inverse of 1 by root 2. All of you know, I think so. 45 degrees is the and critical angle of that surface known as prism critical angle. And okay, sir, this is general way of asking question. Some tricky way of asking questions in the examination paper, what way we can find it? They can ask you like this: what is the deviation of the light? Deviation means what? Angle between the incident light, this is original path, is incident, and emergent light is like this. This is called angle of deviation. Angle of deviation is this much. And that is deviation equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2 or A, sir. That is I1 equal to 0, I2 90 minus R1 0, R2 C. What is your answer, sir? 90 minus C. How to check my answer is correct or wrong? You can understand very clearly from the diagram. Deviation is this. This angle is 90, my answer should be less than 90, it is correct. Less than 90, 90 minus C means more than 90 or less than 90? Less than 90. That means the deviation is correct, sir. So in this way, they can put some tricky question for you like this. Sometimes they can ask you like this also, sir. Take care. That is, angle of the prism also they can ask. Angle of the prism is what? What is our basic condition? R1 plus R2. This type of questions you can expect in the local exam known as Eamcet. R1 plus R2, that is equal to what, sir? C. This is the way of asking question based on conceptual wise. Numerically, nothing is there in the problem, sir.